Now I'm honored to introduce to you one of the good ones, an elected official who went to St. Paul and never lost his way. Instead of bowing to convention and becoming part of the problem, his steadfast conviction of principles has changed the culture at the Capitol. Here's a rare man, one who entered public service as a senator and didn't change his convictions to fit in. I give you Senator David Hann.
Is this on?
Yep.
Thank you. Thank you all for being here today. We're greetings from the legislature. We're here at Ground Zero, the Ground Zero for the Taxapalooza we're facing. And, you know, this is where all good things come from. All jobs are created. What? That's what Mark Dayton tells us. That's what Tom Bach tells us. That's what Paul Thiessen tells us. You know, maybe it's time the people of Minnesota stop listening to Mark Dayton and stop listening to Tom Bach and stop listening to Paul Thiessen and start listening to us. And if you remember the election last fall, maybe you want to forget about it, but we remember the election. And you remember from the Democrats, what did you hear? Did you hear them promise us that they were going to give us the highest tax rates in the country? Do you remember that?
Yeah.
I don't remember that. Do you remember that they promised us they were going to inundate us with fees and mandates? Do you remember that promise?
Yeah.
I remember that. Do you remember that they were going to promise to micromanage our lives? Do you remember that promise? I don't remember. No. You mean they lied to us?
Yeah.
I guess they did. But what have they been doing the last 4 months here in Minnesota? Well, let's begin with $2 billion, with a B, billion dollars in tax increases, income taxes targeted at the middle class. And that's not all. They've got a list of proposed taxes that goes on and on. And let me just give you the short list. Clothing, gas, beer and other alcoholic beverages, sports memorabilia, digital downloads, car insurance, vehicle wheelage taxes, energy taxes for solar projects, silica sand mining, the snowbird tax, the tax on snacks. This is my favorite. Potato chips, corn chips, pretzels, cheese puffs, pork rinds, popcorn, not unpopped, just the pop kind, nuts and seeds, licorice, cookies, cakes, pies, donuts, ice cream. It goes on and on and on. And remember when they said that we needed to raise revenue so that we could fund all those priorities in state government that the Republicans had neglected when we were in charge? Well, here's some of the things they've been spending money on. We have $300,000 for the submarine party, $3.4 million for snowmaking in northern Minnesota, $840,000 for exotic overseas trip for artists to places like Bora Bora, $7 million for the sculpture garden, $360,000 so that we can rebrand the bureaucratic programs in state government. That's so important. $100,000 for the Tree Museum, $15 million for grants to do things like fund community vegetable gardens. It just goes on and on. And this is only part of the $3 billion in overall spending increases the Democrats have proposed in their budget. And what is truly remarkable about this spending is there is not a reform in sight. Instead, what have we gotten? The health insurance exchange, part of the federal takeover of health care. It's going to raise our premiums, increase taxes, create this bureaucratic management of health care, and limit our freedom to choose our doctors. We've got the elimination of graduation standards and rolling back of teacher testing requirements. We've had numerous bills on gun control. Remember that promise? Forced unionization of daycare. And of course, then there's the laundry list of laws that are supposed to help our lives get better. Like, here's one, the bill to ban the use of bicycles to carry more than one person. You know, this is what we call the law against fun, right? How about the bill to require all bus stops to be equal? I didn't know they were unequal. I guess that's my problem. A bill to regulate cat attacks. Now, I'm not really a cat person, but what I know about cats is they don't really listen, so how are you going to regulate? But you know, that's typical. Pass a law and something gets done. We got an 11-person committee to review the paint colors for bridges, and that's so important. Now, here's another one we just did this week. We have a law that is going to tell parents how to put their children down when they take a nap. Can you believe it? I'll tell you what, hardworking taxpayers in Minnesota cannot afford to give one more dime to wasteful, inefficient government. Hardworking taxpayers cannot afford to spend more money on ineffective programs that do not improve our lives. Hardworking taxpayers cannot afford to waste their time on excessive regulation and government mandates. Hardworking taxpayers cannot afford Mark Dayton and the DFL majorities in the legislature. Now, on Monday, in this building behind me, we're going to take up the tax bill in the Senate. And the DFL is going to be serving up the biggest taxapalooza in the history of the state, and we're going to be paying for it. Spring break is over. It's time to pull the plug on government gone wild and get back to the priorities the people of Minnesota expect. And you know what? They're getting nervous in there. So call your legislators, email them, hold them accountable. Help us fight them every step of the way, and we're going to succeed. Thank you for being here. Thank you for your support. God bless you. And I want to introduce...